What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 3 of So You Want to Be a Powerlifter. This episode is all about registering for a meet. I just smashed a lot of caffeine, and I'm feeling a good video coming on. So the first thing you're going to want to do is find out what the most local level of your federation is, and you're going to want to find their website. We're going to put some links in the description below to the IPF, to 100% Raw, and hopefully through that you guys can find out where you need to be and find your federation's website. Once you get to the website, you're going to need to choose a meet. So the way I tell my athletes to look for a meet is look for a block of time, usually 12 to 16 weeks, where you can get a good amount of training in, where you're not going on any major vacations, where you're not renovating your house, you're not having a baby or something crazy like that, but some period of time where you can put the work in and get yourself a good result at the end. Once you've decided on a meet, you want to make sure it's a local level meet. There's a lot of varying levels of competition in powerlifting. There's open meets, which is generally what you're looking for as a first-time lifter. There's going to be provincial or state level meets. There's going to be national level meets and international level meets. And you want to make sure you're not registering for something that requires some competition experience or requires a qualifying total if you don't have those things. Another thing you can do is you'll often get the contact information for the meet director when you look at the potential meet you might be registering for. So if you're not sure whether it requires a qualifying total or anything like that, if it doesn't say on the entry form, then you can email those guys or girls and ask them if you have the requirements to be able to compete. So another thing to take into consideration is the fact that you'll probably end up having to pay a fee to enter the meet and to compete there, but there's also probably gonna be a membership fee to join the federation or the governing body that's gonna be putting on the competition. For example, in my federation, I have to pay $45 a year to the CPU, or the Canadian Powerlifting Union, and then on top of that, I pay $35 a year to the APU, which is my provincial governing body. Now, you're gonna get this document, and you're gonna open it up, and it's gonna be a registration form. Now, I'm sure you can fill in your name, your date, birth, your address, and all that kind of stuff, but you're gonna come up to the weight classes and the age groups. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna talk a little bit about those. Now, most powerlifting federations are gonna be doing everything in kilograms. The competition weights are gonna be in kilograms, your weigh-ins are gonna be in kilograms, and a lot of times your weight classes are gonna be in kilograms. So in the IPF, for men, there's 59, 66, 74, 83, 93, 105, 120, and 120 plus weight categories for the men. For the women, there's 47, 52, 63, 72, 84, and 84 plus as weight categories. Keep in mind other federations will vary slightly. The other thing you're gonna need to know about is age categories, but generally those are gonna be listed on the entry form, so it should be easy enough to figure out. The biggest piece of advice I can give you as a first-time competitor is please, for the love of God, don't sweat your weight class. Don't worry about cutting for your first meet. You don't need to drop 20 pounds to come in to try and be competitive to break this record or beat that guy. If it's your first meet, just come in where you come in. Come in a little fat and happy, you know? Eat a burger, drink some water, do whatever you normally do on the day before a meet or the day of a meet, and just come in healthy and happy and hydrated and in a good place and hit some PRs. Once you get a little bit of competition experience under your belt, then you can look at making weight, cutting weight, moving around, jostling through the weight classes and seeing where you're gonna be most competitive. But please, just compete where you compete at your first one. That's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in and for coming along with us on this awesome journey to your first powerlifting meet. If you enjoyed the video, leave a thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to catch the next one. We're going to be talking about training for a meet in the next video, the standards you're going to need to train to, what's deep enough, and we'll see you there.